70cc motards out there on the track, and lead bike. Points wise, Josh Walland, followed by Cameron Mayo, Josh Devons, Jared Freeth. 217, 209, 174, 139, 124 points in sixth place for Seth Arthur Watson. So still tight out the front with just 8 points between first and second. Two wins for the Reed rider in the second, and one win, and in fact, the third and two thirds, and a win for the second place. Last 2 days, so we'll have to keep you in the loop with those three. In fact, there's a four-lap race for the final of the motards. Most of them round Toyota Quarter, all good as gold. We've got someone taking it, making a break, and when I say making a break, it's only by about four bike lengths, but we go back and there's two, four, six riders in that big gaggle there, and we go back for a little bit of a gap down to the rest of them and pack the pack field and 70cc motard racing at its best in four laps, and we now make these petrol tanks under the hip and hook out. It's sort of motion in itself. It's a difference with any sort of motor vehicle, and something I haven't sort of paid attention to. Something may be up to me, but I suspect the day is running thin and no one's listening too much to get up and get the running round in the 22nd, 1 minute 10 seconds. So now on the 70cc motard, this is 104.316 back in 2014. I'm not sure what's changed in terms of the rules, but we won't get any of that yet. I don't know if you want to. We might do lap times and overall results as the tail enders go through the battle from now on. Just right from the bottom. See the numbers from this distance, so I think that's who it is out there. Mike can come around the slip road, change of speed there for Mike in second place, seems to have the leads there, but evenly matched coming over the front straight, the white flag is out, so it does say 2 laps to go on the timing screen, but indeed it's Ben Owens gone through in the front, Josh Walling down in second spot, followed by Cameron Mayo, still Cameron Mayo the fastest lap. But he was got two seconds, 2.2 seconds slower than the last lap. So it's the fastest lap, right? So okay, the Toyota Quarter there. This is the final lap, according to the white flag out there. You've got to run to the laps indeed, but as the time went through, it clicked down to one lap. So we've got that side to side coming through turn two here at Manfield, and it's up also a little faster. Long line on the outside was Ben Owens, but Long runs right there, so that's entirely the chances of doing that. And he's been tankering getting a win here, unless of course Ben Owen makes some sort of mistake, which may or may not happen. Matters in the way. So a clean run to the finish, and it will be Ben Owen there. 2:42. Josh Wallen, Bennett Owen actually scored the fastest lap here, 1:04.62. Payton's about 0.3 off the lap record. Wallen in second for the Taupo Aotearoa. In the first, 2:40. Brecken, Cameron there in 7th spot, Cheville Ross followed by Tyler Merwood, Cody Osborne on the number 11 bike, that's the top 10, Jared Freeth, Bailey Smith, George Burling, George Fennell, Connor Doreen, and Mitch Fabin there, round up to top 16, Aspen Kennedy, Goodwin, Jordan Bowles, and Hayden Fraser, that's the 19 to have available on the screen, so Victor Bernard.